Welcome. This is the energy vibration reading for the Tarot, the Leo Sun, Moon, and Rising. It is the it's a positive time. It is the first quarter of the year 2018, and the energy vibration for you guys is justice. So whatever the situation is, that whatever that spell is happening for you guys, if you have a legal situation, you're going to win. You're going to win big time. This is going to be good because it's as if the universal angels and guides are going to come in. So whatever the situation is, whatever that has transpired, whatever is happening, there is going to be a win-win situation, and you're going to come out of whatever that is happening in a positive way. Okay, so let's look at what is happening for you Leos. In January, you have the energy of the Eye Princess. The energy of the Eye Princess is a water energy. It is a spiritual month for you Leos. I'm sorry, I said Gemini's. Leos, for you Leos, is a positive month, and it is a good month for you Leos. Whatever is happening, this is going to be very positive and very good. As we move on to the month of February, it's a wonderful positive energy on the, because you can see in the month of February the energy of the Hermit. Whatever is happening, whatever is transpiring in the month of February, it is a positive energy because you are seeing the truth about a situation. You are now seeing finally the truth of a situation. And what is happening with the truth of the situation, you are moving away from the situation and understanding exactly what has transpired. So justice prevail as it is, justice prevail, and it's going to have a situation for a lot of you that you have to deal with kids. Some of you are going to be divorcing and realizing that you have done the right thing. Some of you are going to win lawsuit. It's going to be a very positive time for a lot of you because this energy of spirituality comes up on the Eye Princess in the month of January. Let's see what for you Leos is connecting January to February for you guys. And you have the energy of the Princess of Cups. The energy of the Princess of Cups. So let's look at the situation and let's understand what has transpired. The energy of the Princess of Cups. The Princess of Cups is someone who is, the Prince of Cups, sorry, the Prince of Cups is someone who is between the ages of 25 and 45. And this Prince of Cups is here. Whatever the situation that is transpiring, whatever that is happening with this Prince of Cups, you are going to see a situation for what it is. It is an higher energy, an higher spirit. This Prince of Cups could be someone who really cares about you. There's the energy of justice that is happening, and this Prince of Cup is really helping you to see something that you weren't seeing before. And this is good because what is happening is that this Eye Princess is coming in, bringing in this Prince of Cups, and he is bringing inner wisdom and guidance to you, which is very good. You know, this is very wonderful because you're a fire sign and you're a Leo. And what is happening is that this energy vibration of the Eye Princess is coming in using this energy vibration of this Prince of Cups. And what it is doing, this Prince of Cups has the energy of the Hermit. This Prince of Cups is bringing you this Prince of Cups is really bringing you inner wisdom and guidance. So for you Leos out there, whoever you are, whether you're a man or a woman, the Eye Princess is your spirit guide, sending you people, sending you someone who is between the ages of 25 and 45. And this person is going to help you to see a situation that you weren't seeing before, and this is going to be good because it's as if oh my gosh, now I'm seeing it. Oh my gosh. So For you, Leos, if you have someone who is passed away, if your mother and father has passed away, they are going to send you someone. So as if this person is just going to come in your life and just be there for you and just be very supportive and be very kind and gentle to you, and this is going to be good. Whoever this person is, you are going to see that this person is going to be there. It's as if they have orchestrated this. So if your mother and father has passed away, and they are sending this young 45 who is going to help you with a situation, okay? Let's see what is the connection between the month of February and March. The energy of the world comes out for you. Oh, isn't this wonderful? Yes, it is. You're seeing something clearly now. Yes, it is. Yes, it is. Okay. So there is something that is coming out that is very clear about a situation that is happening. And whatever is happening, there is as if a karmatic balance is happening. There is a balancing. There's something that has happened on earth. There is karmatic situation that now is going through the justice system, or a group of people who are really seeing the truth of a situation. And this is very wonderful. This is very good, because what is happening here is that if your spirit guides, if your father and mother isn't passed over to the spirit world, your spirit guides, the goddess and goddess and the goddesses, because the eye princess bring forth the energies of all the goddesses that is helping you, and the energy of the hermit bring forth the energy of all the ascendance masters who are helping you. And what is happening here is that they are coming in and bringing someone to you that is a Pisces, a Cancer, or a Scorpion, or it could be your son is connecting. So let's say that you're a married couple, and you have a child that is a Pisces, Cancer, or a Scorpion. You are coupling up with them, and you are seeing exactly what is happening. You know, it's as if your spirit guides are sending you this person, and this person is going to come in and help you. What is connecting February with March and new beginning is the energy of the world. Isn't this beautiful? The energy of the world. So for you Leos, you know, you guys are lucky in so much sense. Sometimes you don't see it. Sometimes you think that it is so hard, but it's not hard, because you know, between February and March, you're going to have the energy of the world. So a lot of you, especially people who are starting their businesses, new projects, new businesses, the spirit guides and angels are watching over you. I love this deck. I'm getting such a positive energy from this deck. Your spirit guides and angels are watching over you, and they are showing you the way forward and the energy of the world, a new beginning. And this is because your spirit guides are helping you to open up these ways forward. So let's see what is going to be your final outcomes for you, Leos, for the first quarter of 2018. And you have the 8, the 9 of Cups. Your wishes and dreams are coming true. Isn't that wonderful? Yes, it is. This is wonderful. This is positive. This is really, really a positive situation. The 9 of Cups, and the 9 of Cups energy is a very, very much beautiful. Your wishes and dreams are coming out, and this is positive, because what has happened and what has transpired for you, Leos. I love doing the readings for you, Leos, because what is happening, I love doing the readings on overall, but for you, Leos, there is just certain things that happen for you, Leos, that is so positive. And this is good, because your wishes and dreams are coming true. You have the 9 of Cups, and there is a complete success, pleasure and happiness, wishes fulfill, complete and perfect realization, of pleasure and almost perfect happiness, self-praise, vanity, conceited, much talking of self, yet kind and lovable, and maybe self-denying. There within, higher realms, not easy, satisfied with small and limited idea. Attempt to be male through too much self-assurance, a good generosity, but maybe foolish at nature. I'm reading that and it sounds like me. Okay, so this is wonderful. This is wonderful, Julius. This is so wonderful. This is a wonderful and a positive situation that is about to happen for you. And this is beautiful because what is happening, you are the first sign to get the energy of the world. You're the first sign to get the energy of the world. And the energy of the world with justice is a wonderful, positive energy for you, Leos. And I'm so happy that you guys got the energy of the world. So it's going to be positive. Whatever legal matters, whatever injustice, whatever conflicts, whatever that is happening, your wishes and dreams are going to come true, that the end is going to finally come, and what you desire is going to come to you. So this is very, very positive. So let's move ahead and let's look and see what is happening. I have complete control over my thoughts. Number 15. I have complete control over my thoughts. You can find yourself in an endless loop where you're explain that you find negative because of the negative behaviors of someone else. But if instead you take control of your own emotion, you think and improve your thoughts because it's feels better to do so, you can turn it around. You have no real control of what and anything else is doing with their vibration or with their action for that matter. But you have complete control over your own thoughts, vibration, emotion, and point of attraction. And this is good. So this is a wonderful energy. So remember that you always have, always have all the thoughts and situation over all that is happening. Okay, let's move forward, and we're asking Archangel Metatron to show us the energy for the Leos. And you have tangent journey, and let's see, tangent journey. The frequency of the tangent journey helps us to unlock the inner knowledge and wisdom that we instinctively hold about how to reach a state of oneness and completion through our sensual experience with ourselves and with another. Isn't this beautiful? Yes, it is. It is beautiful because that this is exactly what this reading is all about, because it comes up with the energy of justice, and justice is always balancing out all that is injustice. The High Priestess and the Hermit is together beside each other, January and February, and what it is bringing in is someone of a water energy that is from the unseen world, and this could be a Pisces who is a Neptune. And this is bringing this in to help you to open up the energies to the world. And this is going to be wonderful. So this is good because a new beginning is going to happen in the month of March. Whatever you were working on is going to appear to you. Whatever your wishes and dreams is and was is going to happen because you also have the Nine of Cups. So isn't this wonderful? Yes. I want to say congratulations to you, Leos. Look at this card because it's a card of activation. So come back and really focus on focus on the card, because it's an energy of activation. It will help you to accelerate your journeys so that you can unlock either knowledge and wisdom. And it really, really helps, because I remember the first time I tried it, I was like, oh my God, I'm feeling something. And sometimes if you look, it's like you can see that the energy of, yeah, there. So it works. I can say that it works, because it works. It really, really do works. So ladies and gentlemen, this is a wonderful energies for the first quarter for you guys. I am loving extremely. I saw these cards and I find them to be just really different. If you do cards and you'd like your cards to be tested, I do test cards. So you can just send me a pack of the cards, just mail me, and I will tell you where to send me these things. So I want to say to each and every person, thank you so much. Thank you for supporting me on this journey. And this is going to be a wonderful first quarter for you guys. It's going to be good, because it's opening up and your wishes and dreams are going to be coming through. I'm not doing the energies of the numbers, because it's a quarterly reading and I was not guided to do that. I do that in a monthly reading, so you can use that frequency in the month.